Hello, everybody. Happy Friday. Hope you're having a great, great day. I'm so glad we've got this time together. I got Chad back with me again today, and we're talking about wait. Have you ever had to wait on anything or feel like you're in the wait of a promise, waiting for God to move, waiting on circumstances around you to change? I think, Chad, we all get there from time to time. But I love that analogy that you gave us yesterday about birth, about, you know, when you and Ashley, of course, you know, as parents, we're all there and we can't wait for that moment, but we also got to realize that God is always at work, isn't he?
Absolutely. You know, I kind of go back to a conversation we were having earlier in the week about God is a God of reproduction and not production. Mm. Therefore, everything that God's is going to have a period of waiting. Mm-hmm. There's always going to be a time in there because he's going to be developing something. He's going to be maturing something, naturing something. And I think, again, that's going back to realizing the nature of our God instead of saying, this is what I want, but what's the nature and the heart of God for us? And that takes time so many times.
Well, you know, according to scripture in God, you know, because we operate in time, you know, God is eternal. And we put God sometimes into our thing called time. And we operate on a 24-hour day, 65 or 66 days a year, something like that. And so we put everything in that, knowing that God is eternal. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I start getting anxious because of time factors. Yes. And the scripture talks about things like this, about the time of life. Mm-hmm. In other words, he set a time from mother and having a child from conception to when that child would be born. Now, as parents, sometimes we just can't wait for it to get here. Absolutely. As grandparents, I've got a new grandchild coming, supposed to in April, but I can't wait, to be honest, because I love grandkids. But you know what? I don't want that child to come one moment before time because it has to develop and grow. Everything about that child is developing. Mm-hmm. So there is a time of life. God also talks about set times. Mm-hmm. In other words, there's moments of time that God had set that he was going to do certain things.
Yes.
And sometimes, no matter how hard it is or how much we want it to happen, we really can't push that, I don't believe, before time.
No.
But I think it's in the moment that I call wait. Chad, how do we encourage our people? How can we keep them? We talked about fear, using it yesterday, anxiousness. How can we help them stay focused in the time of wait? What do you suggest to them?
The biggest thing for me is first off focusing on what did God say? Like, why do I feel like I'm waiting right now? Is it because of, you know, that God's growing something? You know, I have something right now that's in my heart that's going around, you know, and several weeks ago, God, you know, more or less said, wait, and it was a stirring season. I'm a planner. I like to know everything A to Z. And quite honestly, all I have right now is A. And it's driving me nuts. But at the same time, I go back to that word that I know God said that this is a stirring time. So every time I begin to feel that anxiousness build up, I constantly remind myself, God, this is what you said. So continue to stir me in this season. So I always go back to, you know, we say that all the time with the prophetic words that come into our life. Always go back to that word. Go back to the word of what God says. And that's the biggest thing for me. And then just focusing on who he is. You know, like I said Sunday on the platform. The continual reminding of who God is in my life is the greatest thing for focusing through any of this, because it is so easy to get distracted in the moment or in the feelings. But just saying, God, you are God. God, you are my joy. God, you are my trust. You are everything I need in you.
I love that, Chad. I love what you said, because I don't, you know, having different personalities. I'm not quite the, I guess you could say, the planner or the detailed person that you are.
Yeah.
And I have a tendency to do things, you know, kind of spare the moment. I can do it like that. I love moments when we come on it like this. Like I can say, Chad, come set with me. He don't have a clue where I'm going. Okay.
You don't have a clue where I'm going.
I know. But see, my temperament or my makeup allows me to operate like that. Mm-hmm. You know, Diane has told me over time, she said, Zach, not everybody can operate like you do, you know, because I am so spontaneous sometimes. And there's nothing wrong with either side, because it gets the, I think both sides gets things done.
Yes.
But I think that can play a role in something. Because see, guys like me, God said, okay, why isn't here? Where's it at? Why don't I have that answer today?
Yeah.
And as a planner, you know that there's certain things that you see the outcome, but you know we're not going to get there in a moment.
Yeah.
And I think it's sometimes it's the very same thing in the spirit realm, that we're almost demanding, or we just, God, you're not answering me because I don't get it today.
Yes. No, absolutely. And that's, I, you know, I had that conversation last week with somebody. I was like, God's always answering. We're just not always tuned to what the answer he's given us.
Yeah.
And that's, again, that's that thing. It's like, God, I want to know.
You know, there's a passage. I've used this all week long, or for the last few days anyway. I'm reading the same passage from Philippians out of the Passion Translation. It says this: don't be pulled in different directions or worried about a thing. Be saturated in prayer throughout each day,
yes,
offering your faith-filled requests before God with overflowing gratitude.
Yes.
So I want to encourage you today, don't be pulled in many directions. Trust the Lord. Stay focused on Him.
Amen.